dreamed that he stood in a shadowy court where the snark with a glass in its eye, dressed in gown bands and wig, was defending a pig on the charge of deserting its sty.
Last night I was standing in a court of law, and the snark was the counsel for defense. He was trying to establish the innocence of a pig that I clearly saw, as stated herein before, in a court of law. So they missed a lot, and some were listening and some were not. So the judge cried, I implore, bring it down to a deafening roar in this court of law.
Let's teach it a lesson it'll never forget. For a devious deed it will live to regret. It's clear that the pig must die. We're of the opinion the pig must pay. We can't let it live for another.
I beg you, my learned friends, for it seems to me with the naked eye that the pig can live or the pig can die, and its happiness all depends on the mercy that now extends from my learned friends.
Let's teach it a lesson it'll never forget. For a devious deed it will live to regret. It's clear that the pig must die. We're of the opinion the pig must pay. We can't let it live for another day. We fear if the rules apply. It's clear that the pig must die. Let's teach it a lesson it'll never forget. For a devious deed it will live to regret. It's clear that the pig must die. We're of the opinion the pig must pay. We can't let it live.
Sentence, the judge being quite too nervous to utter a word. When it rose to its feet, there was silence like night, and the fall of a pin might be heard.
Let's teach it a lesson it'll never forget. For a devious deed will live to regret. It's clear that the pig must die.
We're of the opinion the pig must pay. We can't let it live for another day.
We fear if the rules apply. It's clear that the pig must die.
But their wild exultation was suddenly checked when the jailer informed them with tears such a sentence would have not the slightest effect, as the pig had been dead for some years.